Ian Van Tuyl here in sunny San Pedro, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 1986 Nauticat 33. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer.
Okay, so here we are looking at the Nauticat 33, and as you can see, this vessel is very unique, beautiful, has some incredible lines. We have a stainless steel davit system here off the back, stern anchor there, mounting for a outboard, a really nice barbecue, and all of the varnishing has been redone lately. There is a stern steering station from back here, and then as you can kind of look forward, we're moving into this amazing cabin top that gives you this deck salon, little mini mega yacht type of feel. So I'm going to take you to the foredeck here, and as you can see, the teak has been all oiled, the hatches have been upgraded. You're going to see some of that new privacy shield inside that has been done, but a great use of space. Large electric windlass here, the anchor has just been re-galvanized, but you have a bow roller up here, nice bowsprit, and again, the varnish is absolutely beautiful. Great use of space, and again, a real stylish design here. So if you're looking for just a great vessel to do some exploring with, you're going to be able to accomplish this and have a unique design as you're doing it. So we're working our way back to the aft of the vessel. And again, as you can see, there's just lots of places to be able to lounge out in, to just utilize this space. Beautiful barbecue that's been mounted here, the flagpole. Again, the attention to detail on all the varnish around here is just really classily done. Here is the wheel with two bench seats off the starboard and port side. All of the inside mirrors have been, the window's been tinted with kind of a mirrored image, really giving it a cool, unique look. But you have your compass or throttle. We also have a tri-data repeater here, and just a great use of space and a cool design, as I mentioned. There's also a stern thruster that has been recently added as well, too, giving you that peace of mind to have that maneuverability. Here we are walking into the salon of the vessel, and this is really cool. We have really nice seating around the salon itself. This vessel can actually accommodate 7 people. This right here being an area that somebody could sleep in, but a dining table, when it's not in use, this will push back. You'll see from a picture, and you can have access out to starboard and port side. Large overhead sliding opening sunroof. This is really trick. Right now there's a cover on top of the glass, but even in this scenario, you have great light and great visibility. Here at the lower helm, you can see a real traditional classic wheel. We have a Raymarine E80 chart plotter here, all the breaker switches, lots of storage underneath this cabinet top here as well. Stereo system, our Raymarine ST60 speed. And then we have our tank indication gauges, amps, volts, engine RPM gauge. There are currently 3,318 hours on it, soon to be 19. Again, we have our oil pressure, PSI gauges, and what have you, depth repeater, and then the autopilot control here, along with the windlass up and down remote switches here. So again, great use of space. They've done a cool job here. And looking aft, this goes into our, I would say, master cabin. And coming down below here, the cabin is situated quite nicely. We have a nice large berth off to the starboard side, flat screen television, a good amount of storage throughout, a little built-in sink here, and just cool classic design. This is our aft head and shower. So this is a manual pump head. And then as we move up forward, we have a electric head that was just to put in. But again, you can see just a really nice, comfortable cabin here. There's been upgrades with electric switches. There's heaters with thermostats built into it, and also a portable air conditioning unit that comes with the yacht. Coming up forward into the kind of main part of the galley dinette area, we have double stainless steel sinks, large countertop space. We have a built-in newer modern fridge, and then a really nice classic stove and oven compartment situated here. But again, this is what we're talking about. The owners have done a neat job of kind of modernizing the windows, giving you that privacy, but yet letting that natural light come in. But a neat galley. And then directly across from us is the salon and or the dinette, I should say, salon dinette combination. But again, neat feel to it, real classic look. You can see there's the vessel itself in an art rendering, 12 volt fans. The owners also put in lithium batteries with an inverter. I mean, lots of cool trick stuff done. Look, I mean, handholds everywhere you go. And again, the woodwork is really beautiful. Hanging locker to the side, new microwave here. As we go up to the V-berth, you can see, again, this is a nice area up here. Definitely will accommodate two people, flat screen television. That's an AC-DC with built-in DVD player, 12-volt fan as well. And then you have your head and shower compartment here, mainly used as a head compartment. But this is a electric macerating toilet. And then your sink and additional stowage throughout. Got a nice mirror on this side as well. And again, just a cool use of space. Real classic teak and holly floors and giving you a nice view here looking aft. There's that overhead skylight roof. And again, if you're looking for a real unique kind of classic cruiser, take a serious look at this Nauticat 33. Well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. There will be a link below to the listing with full photo shoots and additional information on the vessel. But if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional videos like this and my latest listings that are coming to you before they even get on the market. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.